In this episode, we're going to paint a German Grenadier. In this case, it's an NCO. So, Fuel Grey, there's a number of colours that I use and that anybody could possibly use. This example, I'm going to paint with Panzer Aces German Tank Crew to Fuel Grey. That's number 335. So this is the base colour with the shade already in place as the German Camo Black Brown undercoat. So I'll be looking to pick out the folds, leaving just enough shade to give the shape without dominating things too much. I'm just going to work around the trousers in the first instance. Here I'm leaving some shade to help create a bit of shape on the bottom of the trousers there. Freshen the brush a little. And that's okay. Now the front of the tunic's quite busy, there's quite a lot going on, the straps and the details of the uniform itself. So I'm going to start with a collar. And go around the back. Now there's no real space back there. Let me see, there might be enough. I might be able to get a tiny little dot of green in between the straps that go over his shoulders, so I'm just putting that in there just to reduce the levels of shade. Just manage it a little. And whilst I'm here at the back, I'll do the back of the arms. Follow that around, there's some clear folds in the arms there. And be sure to follow the shape of the arm right the way around its circumference. Otherwise it kind of just disappears into large areas of shade in beside the body. And then join up the arm along its length. Just going to clean that brush off a bit. It's got a bit clumpy and dry. The lights I'm painting under just now are speeding up the process of the paint drying on the brush. And painted those lines in, leaving some shade. I'm just joining it up with a line down the back, or the side rather, of the arm, and then just a nice simple filling in down the back there. There's also a tiny little bit of tunic showing here, so we'll just catch that, otherwise it'll probably just stay as a dark line. So there's not actually too much in the way of pockets sculpted on this guy. So all I'm going to do is paint in that panel and that panel. If there was pockets, I would have picked them out individually. And then paint below the belt. And that's the basic coat on the uniform. So my chosen shade highlight colour for that base colour is Panzer Ace's Africa Corps Tank Crew. That's 336. And I'm going to use a tiny little thin small brush for this. Got to make sure that the paint is nice and thin so it flows off the brush but thick enough to stay on the feature. Now I'm going to put these highlights as close as possible to the areas of deepest shade. That way I'll create the best level of contrast. Closer, just try to keep it out of camera shot. Right, okay, so there and there. Highlights right beside the shade. If you put the highlight in the middle of the high point of the sculpt, for instance, it quite easily just gets lost, whereas if it's right beside the shade they're working off each other. Right, so that's the trousers, so onto the tunic. There's a little seam there. And just paint along the bottom and then up the other side of that seam, a little bit beside that shadow. That's a bit rough, I kind of went over the shade a little bit there, just trying to get the right angle to show you. So collar, get the highlight on at the bottom, and the brush needs freshened up. Right, let's try and load the brush again, follow that collar around to the back. Keep it in shot, come on. Right. Now the folds on the arm. Simple little lines. That is basically the uniform finish. I'm just going to try and pick this out a bit more. That's uniform finished. Next, I'm going to paint some areas black. Areas that will be painted grey or black with a grey highlight will not show up well against the black brown camo. They'll look as though they have a halo rather than a shade around them. So I'm going to be painting the boots. And they're ready for just a highlight of grey. And then I want to be painting the submachine gun. And then we have the water bottle with metal cap, so I'll paint that with the metal mess tin. So I shall paint that. A little blade coming down there. And the gas mask tin. Whilst we're at it, I'm just going to pick out the waffen farb with a bit of black, which I'll need later on. Right, so that's just going to take a minute to dry. So I'm going to do another couple of areas. I'm going to be using Panzer Ace's Old Wood 310. Now I'm going to start with the bread bag and the galoshes, if that is indeed is what they are called. If I'm painting a larger area, I would use an undercoat for these, and you'll see that on the other videos, but these smaller areas I'm quite happy just to go straight in with this as a main coat. And I've left a bit of shade in. So tucked up in here we have the bread bag, and then we've got what I'm taking to be the zelt pan. So I'm going to put this down as a base colour for the camo. Whoops, brush straight a little. Let's see if I can keep this in shot and still keep the brush accurate. It's went on a bit dry there, but that's fine. So let's go back to the areas we undercoated with black. Going to take German grey. 995, I think that is, model colour 995. First thing I'm going to do is paint some rough highlights on the boots just to try and give them a bit of depth without them being garishly bright. That's all it takes for them. Now, MG, I'm going to try and pick out some shapes. Then we've got the water bottle cap. Mess tin. Try and leave a little bit of shade around all those bits of detail. A little knife. And the gas mask tin. There we go. Now the helmet. Just going to paint that all over with a coat of German Grey. It's a kind of smooth, featureless area, so I'm getting on in a thin coat. Right, as we're waiting for that to dry, I'm going to put a highlight onto the bread bag and the galoshes. So working with a small brush, small amounts of paint, keeping it thin so that it flows well. And it's just a tiny little line that helps bring it out from the background. And a similar approach here. Just putting on enough of a highlight to make them stand out. Then we've got some camo to paint on that silk band. So for the brown element, I'm using Panzerace's Splinter Blotches, that's 347. Using that same small brush. Get the paint on nice and thin so it's flowing okay, and then that's a bit too thin. For the size it says, we really just want to get some brown blobs onto it, nothing more complicated. And then I'm going to use German Uniform model colour 920 for the green element. And this just needs little dots. Simple as that. Then I'm going to take a nice bright colour. Let's see, light mud. I'll take Panzerace's 315 light mud, and I'm just going to pick out the straps. going back to the greys, I want to do an intermediate, well, main colour basically, on that's the German grey is the shade now. So it's going to be dark grey is the main colour for the helmet. That's model colour 994. I'm going to paint this on simply. Oops, let's see. Just around the base. Then leaving shade above that. So you've got a small line of shade. All around like that. That's ready for a highlight. So we shall move on to that for the grey just now. Going to use model colour London Grey, that's 836. The boots are not getting any more of a highlight, so the gun. Dots and dashes to help accentuate the shape. Catch the edges. And then the water bottle cap, just a wee touch there, and then and work around the edges of the mess tin down the middle, though that might, to be honest, have to be a leather strap. I'm just painting it grey. Sometimes too much detail just confuses the eye. My brush is just broke. Right, okay, I'm not for giving up. So, this is the gas mask. Oh, not a line on that. It's actually quite tricky painting with this, guys, but we shall persevere. Too dry. Right. I want to paint some lines along here. There you go. That's a typical shape you would expect to see. And then on the helmet, just around the edge. And then a line to dry. Put a line there to catch that shade, and I'll just quickly do one on the other side. So next up is the brows. I'm just going to pause the recording here because I'm going to have to go and get another brush, guys. This one's seen better days, but might be worth saving. Look at this, we got a new brush and just a... Oops. That's a new brush. That's the old brush. That's years and years of heavy going, so it's done well. So it may be worth, as I said, it might be worth saving. Anyway. Browns. I'm going to move on to browns. The various brown elements on this figure. So they're all going to get the same base coat. German camo. Whoops, I need to bring light back over. My apologies. German camo medium brown 826. Right. So... got the water bottle first of all. Got some straps right in here. And those carry on over the shoulders and down the front. And then around for the belt. And there you go, that's it for leather. And there's no handles or such like on this particular figure. So I'm going to highlight that. This is model colour, orange brown, 981. It's a very, very bright colour. I like to use it as a weathered sort of worn leather edge, and it really helps pop the detail, brings it out from the background of the figure. Now on the water bottle I'm actually going to use this to show the strap, and the water bottle itself will highlight with another colour. So we've got leather here. Just a little bit orange that way, and that way, and then down the front. Just shaping the brush and reloading it. And that edge there, and that just helps the visibility of the strap. And a little bit along the bottom edge there. Doing it along both edges is probably a bit too much orange, so I'll just choose one edge. That will do. Right, next. Going to do the waffen fab. Now I put a coat of black on there. What I'm now going to do is cover it with off-white model colour 820. I'm going to leave black around the edges so that it's nicely framed. There we go. Actually, he's also got a piece of paper in his hand, so I should attend to that just now. I'm going to use that London Grey as a base colour. Not looking to have any internal shade colour other than the London Grey on this. I just turn it that way just now. I don't want any dark shade showing there. I shall go back to the white in just a moment for that. So I've painted a waffle fab. I've got a black edge around it so it's distinctive. I painted it white and I'm now choose the right colour, I think. I'm now going to paint a black line down the middle of the waffle fab, which will create the white edges that you would see for a grenadier. And that'll save you the trauma of trying to paint tiny white edges. Simple as that. Now to be honest, this guy's looking a bit, he's looking a bit bland. Doesn't have a lot of detail on the front, so just freshen up the brush. Going to put markings on his collar too. Oops. Kind of getting the white back out just now anyway for the sheet of paper. Now this could be anything, it could be some written orders, it could be a map, it could be anything, but one thing for sure is it is a piece of paper, and as such, a small piece of paper even, and as such you don't necessarily want to be overcomplicating things by trying to paint something on it. It's a complicated shape and it'll probably just confuse the eye if you try to paint a map or the impression of lettering or such like. So just keep it as a plain piece of white paper. Let's go back to the white. Just put the collar markings on. So we're on to the skin. Base colour for that is not that. Where's it gone? It's gone wandering. Here we go, sorry. Right, base colour is model colour, German camel pale brown. The number's a bit indistinct on this bottle. So as far as hands go, I'm just going to block the whole area in with no internal shade. Now he doesn't have much of a face sculpted on this guy, so I can see the nose, but that's easy enough, it's in the middle of the face. He's got a chin, cheekbone, and cheekbone. Now whilst we're here, he has a chin strap which I'm now going to paint in. I'll use the German Camel Pale Brown as a base colour. Then can move on to highlighting the skin, and I'm going to be using Flat Flesh, model colour 955. It's a bright colour that shows up well against the darker shade colour for the skin. So for the hand, I'll just paint the back of the hand, and then this will be tricky, I'll kind of come in from the top, paint the fingers. He's got a thumb, back of the hand, that's about it. That brush is too dry. And then the face. So we've got paint's not flowing off there. Got a nose. A chin. Got cheekbones. To be honest, that's a bit messy, but I think this new brush needs worn in a bit. Right, and then a quick highlight. I shall use